Hi creators, welcome or welcome back to Academic Phoenix Plus. My name is Monica and I am here to show you some tips and tricks on how to model this beautiful, fantastical environment. In this video tutorial, we're going to cover how to quickly model a tree using the content browser, how to model rocks, and then also how to create a draping flag using nCloth. If you're new to this channel, I post tutorials on a weekly basis. Software includes Maya, ZBrush, Substance Painter, and so much more. So if that is your sort of thing, please consider subscribing. So bring out that creativity, open up that software, and let's go ahead and get started in finishing up modeling this fantasy environment. What I'm going to do now is use the content browser to create this tree. It's going to be very fast. So you can go to Windows, Content Browser, and you're going to find trees. And now I just have to find the right tree. As you can see, there's a variety of trees. Just going to find the one that will match my concept art as best as possible.
I'm just going to click and drag. It's going to be a tiny little thing. Then I'm going to go to Modify, Convert, Paint Effects to Polygons, choose Quad. I'm going to send it a pivot and then scale it up. So very quickly I can get a tree. Now this tree has a lot of branches. So what I can also do is just duplicate this one and then just delete the faces that I don't need. And I'm hoping I can get away with it. We'll see. Just gonna crush it. Let me pick it up.
And just using my reference to make sure that I actually have something accurate. And let me bring back the wall. Okay, so that's pretty close. So then I can grab this one again, I can duplicate it. And I'm going to just grab these guys and assign a new material, and I'm going to choose an Arnold AI standard surface and choose, this is going to be my tree shader. Kind of like a deep red. Okay, let's see what that render looks like. It's getting there. All right, so that's kind of like the idea behind paint effects. All right, so rocks. The thing about rocks is that they can be pretty high poly because they do have a lot of shapes. There's several ways we can start this. We can use a cube and then just basically increase the division. A lot of you will probably start off with a sphere because it kind of makes sense to use a sphere, but my only problem with a sphere is the triangles at the top, and it's very obvious that it's a sphere, so that's why I usually don't use that. And and we're just going to be doing a lot of basically sculpting to make it a little bit more organic and a little bit less like a cube. Some people use ZBrush or 3D sculpting, and I'm going to show you guys sculpting in a second as well. I'm just going to get like a basic shape right now to try to break, you know, you can scale and stuff like that. So it doesn't have to look so cube-like. Have you guys ever seen that really old movie called 300? They also have a rock. It's like the same rock over and over. It's actually really funny. And it became a joke in the set because they just had to move the rock in different angles and it made it look like it was under modeling, I think. Let me, hopefully. There is these sculpting tools that I have to find. And let me see. This is why I like this help command here, because in help and in search, you can actually look for sculpt. And where is it located? Mesh tools surfaces. There it is. So under mesh tools sculpting, there's a range of sculpting tools. You can pull it, you can actually rip this tool by clicking at the top here. And then what we could do is actually click on smooth, for example. Oof, this brush is huge. And let's go ahead and make it small, B, middle mouse and drag. And you can smooth out the mesh a little bit. You can also do the pinch tool and it will actually pinch the geometry for you. So if that's something that you want to do, you can actually start pinching. It's a little hard to see, but you can see that it's actually bringing the vertices closer together. So it will actually start pinching things. And what you can do is also use the grab tool, right? So then you can actually kind of move things around really easily. It's kind of like soft select. It's actually very similar, but it's a nice visual way of seeing how the model is going to react. And a couple of other things that I would probably suggest that you check out, because it's pretty fun. There is something else called Relax. And I personally like Relax because it will soften the geometry, and that's kind of nice. If you guys can notice, there's like these sharp edges, even though I've smoothed it and all that stuff. What we can do is go to Mesh Display and then just say Soften. Whoops, I didn't select my mesh. Try that again. Mesh Display, Soften. And that will soften the edges, right? So that's kind of like a nice way of softening edges. So with, you know, I can kind of start with this one just as an example. But basically what you want to try to do is create several versions of these. I can duplicate it, rotate it, show a different angle, duplicate that one, again, rotate it. We can scale it up. Show the other side. The tree's on the way. To fix that, but so once you have a collection of these, you can actually just grab these and duplicate them, and again you can kind of rotate them, and they will, since I didn't group on anything, they will have their own rotation, and then you can just kind of go in and tweak it from there. So again, you can change the scale, make some bigger, some smaller, and then when we get to the texturing phase, we'll be able to do more with it. Now, when it comes to rocks, it's important to have big ones, but it's also really important to have small ones too, because that it reads better. I wanted to show you the render, so it was just kind of nudge a couple of little things. I added an extra branch to the tree, and then I just kind of pushed these rocks inward so that it kind of starts creating a little cave. And right now I'm just basically doing a quick little render to see how everything is shaping and if it's looking relatively similar to the concept art. Now, we do have still a little ways to go, but still I think we're getting pretty far along in a very short amount of time. I did wanted to show you guys a couple of things such as dynamics. nCloth is, again, one of those really great things that you could use to model something quickly. So we're gonna grab a plane. Make it long. Again, give yourself plenty of mesh. And before I get started with this, if I'm going to texture it, I highly recommend that you guys UV map it right away. So I'm gonna go ahead and go to modeling, UV map, planar mapping options, and choose Z. So if I attach some sort of texture and it's all full of wrinkles and stuff like that, it would be way challenging to UV map that than a plain surface. So I went ahead and did that. Let's go ahead and bring it in here. So when I take a look here, clearly it's being connected by something, but you know, we can't see it. So what I'm going to do is basically create this. It's going to be my asset, but I'm just going to make it really low poly. So I'm going to use that as my passive, and then I can duplicate it and then just kind of bring it together a little bit. I'm going to delete the history, all that stuff. This is going to be my effects and cloth. And this one's going to be my passive. And then I'm going to grab vertices. Should select that one. Constraint, point to surface. Same thing. Actually, why don't we just watch it? Let's see, just for fun. Whee! So cool. Okay. Focus. All right. Let's go to vertices here. Shift select this one. Constraint, point to surface. Rewind, play. Now, what's neat about passive colliders is that you can actually animate these. So for example, I'm going to go ahead and rewind this. I'm going to hit S for animation, and that after the simulation happens, I can actually move this. So again, I hit an S and then I can see the effect. So then I get a bit more of that cloth look and feel. So something like that. It's not exactly like the concept art because it's a little tighter and it's got a lot more wrinkles. But hopefully that gives you guys an idea. So I might want to rewind this and select this. Maybe not go as far. But what I can also do is maybe grab some of these and also constraint. So that's going to give me a few more folds. So I'm going to do the same thing for here. And I might animate this one too, just a little bit. Right, so that kind of gives you an idea of nCloth. Again, it's a little harder to get exactly these number of wrinkles. You could probably sculpt it and everything. I'm gonna leave it as that, just as an example of nCloth, but I just wanted to demonstrate to you guys what's possible. Once you're happy with it, you can select it, you can duplicate it, and then you can either hide these for now, the simulation, unless you want more. I'm just going to go ahead and group them and then hide them. It's similar color to the tree, so I'm just going to add that in there just for the sake of this blocking. And let me see what that looks like in render cam. And I'm gonna bring this down. It's huge. Let me grab all these rocks and group them. Just want to see how close I am to the reference here. It's like around here. And to be fair, once you have this, you can actually model it. So for example, I can just grab a soft select brush and just kind of whoop. Okay, I think that's close to the reference. Alright, let's take our render.
I think that's a really good place to stop. We have basically completed the block out of this environment. In the next video tutorial, we're going to start talking about UV mapping the environment. We're going to talk about texture density and so much more. And after UV mapping, of course, comes texturing, lighting, and all the fun stuff. So thank you so much for watching. I really appreciate it. Hopefully you learned a thing or two. If you did, please like and subscribe. That is your message to me, letting me know that you like this content and that you want to see more. Also, share my videos. If you know a 3D artist out there that would love to learn how to make an environment, please share my videos. That would make me really happy, and also the YouTube algorithm god's happy too. Encourages me to make more content like this for you. Also, take a look at academicphoenixplus.com. There you can find free resources such as 3D models, ebooks, videos, and so much more. So take a look at academicphoenixplus.com. Again, thank you so much for watching. I really appreciate it. Keep creating, and I will see you next time when we start UV mapping this fantastical environment.